a wonderland of cafes, bars and antique shops, pavements lined with stalls piled high with books, torn and stained with age, trays filled with collectors' coins, postage stamps and trading cards. Mikkel paused, gazing with curiosity at some caged birds, canaries, budgerigards and doves. How exotic they looked. He moved forward and sidled up to an elegant macaw parrot, uncaged but lightly chained to a perch. And what a beauty he was! Bright yellow breast, wings as blue as the sky, and a crown of vibrant green. Unable to resist, Mikkel reached out and gently touched the big black beak. It felt rough, just like the slate blackboard at school.
"Careful, Mikkel," Papa said. "One little peck and you'll say goodbye to that finger."
They moved on. Soon they were passing the western edge of the old medieval town. 2 minutes later, they were strolling along the waterfront, beside the wide, swirling Nervion River. Ahead lay Papa's favourite cafe, its green canvas awning overhanging at the front and offering shade to people seated outside. And there sat the old shoeshine man, with a nose shaped like the macaw's beak. His long jet-black hair swept back and reaching down to his collar. Mikkel had often seen the shoeshine man in this part of town. Today he'd set up his collection of boot brushes, tins and polishing cloths under the cafe's awning. Poised over a pair of brogue lace-ups, he applied the sticky black polish with a few quick swipes of his bare hands. There was a kind of detached aloofness about the way he worked, purposeful, focused and apparently oblivious to the world of hustle and bustle going on around him. The shoeshine man suddenly reached up and ran his polish-stained fingers lightly across the top of his head. "How strange," Mikkel thought. "No wonder the old shoeshine man's hair always looks so black and shiny." At that moment, as if caught by an invisible hand, Mikkel came to a dead stop. He could not speak, and nor could he move. He just stood,